Hi guys, so this is how you can set a 3D wallpaper or use the iOS 26 depth effect. So what you want to do is access your lock screen settings. You basically do this if you're on your apps page like this. You just swipe on the left like that, and then you access your lock screen. Then long press that lock screen to access your lock screen settings. Now you see a button here which says customize. That's where you can customize your image or your lock screen in effect. So I'll start afresh so that I can show you how to add an image to your lock screen. So basically I'm going to choose an image here. As you can see, I have quite a number of images that are there. Let me just choose this one, which I already have on my lock screen. So basically you can see this one has that kind of depth effect to it. So the definition is, if there's reasonable or sufficient distance between you and the background, or it's able to identify that there's a background behind you and there's a blurred effect, you know, those kinds of things, then you are able to just put an image just like this as your lock screen. So this was taken by an iPhone. So most of the pictures that I would have taken using iPhone will obviously work in this instance. So here I can drag down, and as you can see, there's that depth effect there. Now, if you want to set it manually, you come here, the three dots there, if you can see, you click on them. That's where you see that setting depth effect. So it's already selected, but if I deselect it like this, you see the text will come above the object, or the object identified, right, which is me in this instance. But if I say depth effect activated, you see the text will go behind. Now I'll show you with other pictures as well. So in this instance, I will show you with a picture like this one, which was professionally taken using a camera. So you see it's above like that, right? So there's no depth effect here. And naturally, you can't really identify me apart from the background, because my hair is black. Then, you know, the background is also black, so it's kind of difficult. But once I think you start to use the depth effect, you understand more this idea of identifying like objects in your picture. So if I click depth effect here, it will actually do this and identify my face, right, and put the text behind. So obviously if I drag down, you can drag down and do whatever you want with it. So here it has identified me as the object and also put the background behind. So in most cases, most pictures would work in that instance if you want to use them. Now let's say you have a picture which naturally is in 3D, or it's just 2D, or a picture which naturally will not work in this instance. In some cases, you would have to put the picture as 3D. So even this one, which we said is, you know, it has that depth effect to it. If I click on the icon, which is next to the three dots there, there's an icon there. I'm not sure if you can see it clearly, but if I click on it, it will say generating spatial scene. So a spatial scene is basically like a 3D layout of whatever, you know, image you have, right? So this image will naturally be 2D, but it will make it 3D. So if I move my screen like this, you can see it has that 3D effect to it. If I deselect it and I move my image, you see that there's really nothing much. But if I generate my spatial scene, then you see it will bring it forward and it will act as if the image is actually moving. So that's the 3D effect. So in that case, if you're going to use images like this one, so I took this one as part of a image I was creating for a website I created, for PDF pick. However, it is just a phone and like the Android layout of the phone and me holding the phone, right? You can see the text is above, so naturally it's not identifying the phone there. And if I click here, you won't even see depth effect there. So naturally, this won't work as a photo just as it is. But if I say generating spatial scene, which is me creating a 3D sort of scene of this image, you see it'll start to kind of move. Not sure if you can naturally see it on the video, but I hope you can. Now it has created that 3D scene. And if I click on the three dots now, you see depth effect. So the text is above like this. If I say depth effect, you see the text goes below. Now in most cases, obviously, if you try and drag it down, it will work like this. Then you can add your lock screen and save. And in short, this is how you set 3D wallpaper to your iPhone in iOS 26. And also this is how you implement the depth effect on any photo. Now, if everything else fails, like all your photos are not really working properly, then you can manually do this. You can use apps, you can search for apps which just generate that depth effect. All you need is a blur and something that just makes your picture be identified as the object in front. So I saw this application on App Store, which is called FOCOS, F-O-C-O-S. So generally, you can use this to kind of, you know, put that blur effect on your images. Like if you select your image, it will prepare you for editing. And once it selects, you can put that depth there, more like that camera depth. In this case, it won't necessarily be seen because of the image. The image already has that kind of depth effect to it. Because if you are taking photos using your iPhone, naturally you set that depth also. You can set that depth. Then you also put the focus as to where you want that focus to be. So you can use apps like this or any other apps which you see on Play Store to kind of generate that depth effect or that kind of depth to your image. And then you can use them on your lock screen. So this is how you generate a 3D wallpaper and also utilize the iOS 26 depth effect. Do you have any questions? Was this video helpful? Comment down below, like, share, and subscribe.